Naming acids is pretty simple. We categorize acids as either binary acids or ternary acids. Generally speaking, a binary acid contains hydrogen and some other element. A ternary acid contains hydrogen plus oxygen and some other element. Because of their involvement with oxygen, ternary acids are sometimes known as oxoacids. Some examples of binary acids would be things like HCl, HBr, H2S, HF, and so forth. Examples of ternary acids are acids that usually contain a polyatomic ion, such as HNO3, H2SO4, CH3COOH. To name binary acids, we're going to use the general formula. We're going to have hydro, and then the root name of the element that goes with it, and then ic acid. So, for example, here we have HCl. And since the root word for chlorine is chlor, we're going to plug that in, and we're going to make this hydrochloric acid. H2S would likewise be named hydrosulfuric acid. There are a limited number of binary acids. These are mostly going to be elements from group 7, HF, HCl, HBr, HI, and so forth. To name ternary acids, it's useful to be able to recognize the polyatomic ion that the acid contains. For example, HNO3, we can see that it contains the nitrate ion, the NO3- ion. To name HNO3, we're going to notice that it contains nitrate. We're going to change the name nitrate. We're going to drop the ATE. We're going to add an IC and an acid. So this is going to become nitric acid. If we look at H2SO4, we recognize that it contains the SO4, which is the sulfate ion. And so to name that, we are going to drop the 8 from sulfate, and it's going to be sulfuric acid. With CH3COOH, we're going to recognize that CH3COO- is the acetate ion, and so this is going to become acetic acid, also known as vinegar. There are a couple of tricks for naming ternary acids. The first one is to notice that with HNO3, we have the nitrate ion that's going to become nitric acid. If we have HNO2, it's the nitrite ion, and the nitrite ion is going to become nitrous acid. So when we have a polyatomic ion that ends with 8, we change it to ic and add the word acid. If our polyatomic ion ends in ite, we change it to us and add the word acid. Also, just a reminder to watch out for acids that are not dissolved in water. So, for example, if we saw HCl and we saw that it was a gas, that means that that is not dissolved in water, and so we would name that according to the rules for naming covalent compounds. So this would just be hydrogen chloride. Same molecule, now it's dissolved in water. You can tell that because it has the AQ here, which stands for aqueous. The name of this compound is going to be hydrochloric acid. So it's only an acid, technically, if it's dissolved in water. If it's not dissolved in water, you want to use the rules for naming binary covalent compounds.